Now your local forecast from meteorologist Sarah Robleski and your Storm Tracker weather team.
A gorgeous day heading our way as we are expecting warmer and brighter conditions. Waking up to some early fog, temperatures in the 60s, but boy, what a jump we're going to be going into this afternoon as we'll be watching for highs in the 80s. A few afternoon clouds, especially across our southern areas, but most of us stay dry. That wind out of the northwest, about 5 to 15 miles per hour. Yes, it is a beach day, that is for sure, but if you're headed down to the south coast, Cape and Islands, be aware because Hurricane Gert is going to be passing in the open Atlantic well away from us, still going to churn up the seas, and we're going to be talking about a surf up to 10 feet, high risk of rip currents and rip tide out there, especially for those south-facing beaches. Of course, we're going to monitor the situation through the morning news, plus we're taking a look at our next chance of rain as it will arrive before the weekend on Boston 25 News. A 5 a.m. advisory has actually showed that Gert has increased a little bit with winds of 90 miles per hour, moving northeast at 21 miles per hour. But it is far enough away from us, we're not going to see any big impacts except for the waves. They're going to be rocking as the storm continues to race to the north and east. Expected to strengthen to a Category 2 hurricane with winds of 100 miles per hour later on today. So we'll be watching that closely, but it is churning the seas, making some waves out there. The center of it right around 28 feet. Well, closer to home, 5 to 7 right now, but seas will be building anywhere from 5 to 11 feet. And that means our south-facing beaches closest to the center of the storm do have the risk of seeing some rip currents as well as some high surf. So from Westport, we're talking about the Cape and Islands. All these beaches are likely going to be dealing with high surf. The advisory goes from 9 a.m. till 8 p.m. later today. And a rip current is basically a very fast, narrow channel of water that's rushing away from the beach. You can't swim against. It's like a treadmill that you can't get off. You want to step to the side. So swim to the side, parallel to the beach, and then back to the beach. So it's one of those things where it can feel very dangerous when you're in it, and you do not want to try to fight the rip there.
Now your local forecast from meteorologist Sarah Robleski and your Storm Tracker weather team.
A gorgeous day as we have high pressure building on in, and yes, that is a hurricane to our south and east. This is Gert continuing to push to the north and east, churning up the seas though. So one thing you'll notice this afternoon, while temperatures will climb into the 80s, it feels like a great beach day. However, if you're going to be headed to the south coast, the Cape or Islands, just be prepared. You may see some high surf as well as some dangerous rip currents out there. Winds out of the northwest bringing in lower humidity may gust near 20 in the afternoon, but overall we're looking at fantastic conditions. There's that high surf advisory until 8 p.m. today. Could see surf anywhere from 5 to 11 feet, especially for the south facing beaches of the Vineyard and Nantucket, and we'll watch again for that dangerous rip current risk. Coming up later on tonight, Jason Brewer, he's going to have the latest information on that high surf advisory, plus he's going to be timing our next chance of rain.